What's going on? This is kind of a request video. A guy asked me to make a video for if I wanted to ever own my own truck. I'm sorry, your screen name escapes me right now. But I appreciate you asking because that gives me something to talk about. It's kind of hard to figure out things to talk about without messing up or getting into talking about the YouTube drama because I watched that a lot. But, and I don't want to get into that. We turn into that kind of YouTube channel. But I'm back to whether or not I want to be own my own truck. I would love to own my own truck, but the situation has to be correct. I don't know. I need to know more. If I owned my own truck, it would have to be in oil fields. The oil fields would still have to be going strong. Because I'm not that interested in hauling freight. We tried that last winter for a couple of weeks and it just didn't pay. I don't want to be so far away from the house again. I can't come. When oil went down before, I was with company and to keep us working, and they said either we had to go to the road or we had no job, so I went to the road. Well, I ended up all the way out in over out by Vegas, and I had a lot of personal stuff happen, a lot of things happen at home. My grandfather fell, got sick, went through other personal stuff. And I called my boss and said, look, I got to get home, and I got to get home now. It took me 7 days to get back home. So, I know this is not for me. Here, it's not so bad, you know. It sucks, you know, I'm gone, but at least I'm close. I can be home in 2-3 hours, tops. I've mentioned here and there, my dad got sick. I had heart surgery, whatever, he threw a clot in his brain. Whatever, he ended up killing him. But, which is why I didn't work much last year. I got that phone call. I had just came off a pad. And I got the phone call to get home. And that was horrible. But at least I wasn't on the other side of the country and got that phone call. That would have been worse. So, for me to get my own truck, it would have to be a situation where, A, I have the money in the bank. I would need at least $30,000 to $50,000 in the bank after I purchased a truck. Because what I see, what happens a lot, I see this a lot, guys go buy these trucks and they think, oh, I bought a $30,000 truck, okay? Well, yeah, you got a great deal. Whatever. They drive it for a month or two. Things are going great. They think things are awesome. And they start spending the money. And they go, oh, I'm making all this money. I'm making 10 grand a week, whatever, 7 grand a week. It's so great, blah, blah, blah. Fine. You do that. Fine. That's what they do. Then all of a sudden, bought a $30,000 truck. Had about 700,000 miles on it. It was only a 450 horse motor. So now my truck blew up, ran a transmission. They got about a $10,000 bill or they need to deal with because their truck's blown out. But they haven't saved any money, and they didn't have any money to begin with, so they're screwed. I'm just not gonna put myself in that situation. I'm not gonna put my family in that situation. So things would have to be right. Things would have to be good. Right now, if the truck blows up, I just go find another job. If my boss can't get it running in a timely fashion, I'll get another job. I have. Just because I work for somebody doesn't mean I don't have a backup plan. You always have to have a backup plan. I have multiple places that I can go to and be working within a few days. Yeah. So you have to have that, especially if you're in the oil industry, period. Because you don't know what could happen. The president could say something stupid, and which happened last year. He could say something stupid, or Congress could do something stupid, or some judge could do something stupid. These old people freak out, and the next thing you know, there's no work. He basically had no work November, December. Well, December. We had no work in December. And that had to do with the whole political crap. But once that got cleared up, business as usual. So, you gotta be prepared for that. Right now, what I'm doing is kind of nice. I mean, I'm driving a nice W900 with a 280-inch wheelbase. It's an owner-op package. It has every option that they had in 2012. The only thing I don't have is the in-dash crap or radio and all that. So, but they didn't use it back then. I have all the gauges and everything. So my situation right now is pretty good. I guess the answer is yes, I would love to have my own truck. Someday it might be this truck. That would be neat. But I don't plan on driving my entire life. I'm 40 years old now. I'm just not that interested in driving for another 20 years. So hard on your body, and honestly, my metabolism is slow, and I don't eat a lot, but good grief, my weight is crazy. My weight goes crazy, which, whatever, is what it is. So, if I had a my own truck and a job where I was home every day, yeah, I could do this a long time. But as what I'm doing right now, the oil field is not a permanent solution. So I guess you could say I want my own truck. I do. I don't have anything lined up to make that possible. That's not my end goal right now. My goal is to just survive. We've got things that need paid off and paid for, and once that's done, then we'll evaluate. I pretty much work all the time, and you know, I don't want to do that forever.
get in the whole field.
Yeah, right now I would.
I would.
Sure. It's a good way to make a lot of money fast and can change your life. But that's what I'm doing. It's just a quick way to fix your screw-ups or things that happen because life happens. And we all get into situations that suck. Nobody's perfect. I definitely would go back to my roots, which is supervision. Very different from what I'm doing now. My background is super manufacturing supervision. That's my background. But I'll do this for as long as I need. I get in a position where I can take cash for a truck, work here and there. Like some folks I do know, that's what they do. They have their own trucks and they don't work around a year round. They just work here and there when they need to. That's my goal. My ultimate goal, actually. That we're a long way from there. And someday I may end up buying this truck. I may not. I don't know. I might just stay driving with my boss forever. I mean, he's looking at buying a brand new Peterbilt. He's going to drive for a couple years, and I'll get into it. So, basically driving a brand new Peterbilt. So, how can you argue with that? I don't know. I would love to own my own truck, and if I could pull off a way to do it, big cushion of money, then I would. But until that happens, I won't. I'm not even in a position to think about doing that right now. But eventually, I may be. Certainly no expert at any of this stuff. Which goes for most of the people on this YouTube space. They want to think that they are, but they're not. Bad week away from being out of it anyway. A lot of them get knocked out of it, as we've seen. But I don't know. I guess I'm holding up a little too much. But let's just say I hope that someday I can buy my own truck, and if it's not an oil field, then I probably won't do it. But the way it looks, oil's going to be here. Depending on the politics of it, this oil stuff could be around for many, 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 many years. Not just the fracking. I mean, I'm very open to doing other things, but all of the crude oil. There's lots of that. There's going to be lots of servicing wells, doing all kinds of stuff. This oil ain't going away anytime soon. Unless we go to electric, but they use natural gas for electric. So that's what they're getting out here is the natural gas. That's what they're using for power plants anyway. So we'll see. Y'all take it easy.